Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to my WWE 2K23 Universe Mode. Shaman possibly got a live coverage. We're back here today with the final SmackDown of the second week. Well, the second week of June SmackDown, the final show before the In Your House pay-per-view. Of course, this doesn't really affect SmackDown, but hey, it's still going to be a big show nonetheless, guys. We've got 9 matches here for you this afternoon, and we are going to be rolling right in. Undertaker 03's in the main event, a Brock Lesnar, Kofi Kingston in the first match, and that's a rivalry. Ivar and Butch in a rivalry, okie dokie. We've got a triple threat, Gunther, Shanky and Eric. We've got Batista and Sheamus in a rivalry, that's going to be fun. We've got Jimmy Uso and Giovanni Vinci in a rivalry, very, very interesting. Shayna Baszler and Ronda Rousey, Brock Lesnar, the beast incarnate Brock Lesnar versus Big E. A rematch from what should have happened in 2022, but obviously, you know, injury, etc. Roman Reigns taking on main event Jey Uso, what's going to be a belter, and Undertaker 03 taking on the recently victorious over Brock Lesnar, Santos Escobar. We're going to go straight into the first match, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to go right into it. So we're going to have a post-match humiliating attack for one of them, and here we go then. So then, the match here is Brock Lesnar 03 taking on Kofi Kingston. We're going to go straight into the poll as per usual. Brock Lesnar, the man, of course, has beat Kofi Kingston inside 10 seconds to take Kofi's championship off, ironically, on SmackDown. But this, of course, is the old version of Brock Lesnar. Arguably his purest form. And this one should be quite interesting, guys. Let's see how this goes. We've got Brock versus Kofi. Let's kick off SmackDown with a bang next.
Here comes the next big thing. The following contest is scheduled for 1 fall, making his way to the ring from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar.
What a rookie year for this young man, Brock Lesnar.
No, you're not kidding. King of the Ring, multiple WWE titles, and he main evented WrestleMania.
Brock Lesnar has been on a rampage thus far in his career. He's already unseated main eventers and destroyed legends.
Yeah, indeed, his career has grown exponentially in just a matter of months.
He's called the next big thing, but he might be the biggest thing already. Kofi Kingston has been in WWE for well over a decade. Kofi Kingston, who finally realized his dream to become WWE champion.
The New Day from Ghana, West Africa, weighing in at 212 pounds, Kofi Kingston.
A man some would credit with the creation of the power of positivity.
And Kofi Kingston has such a special bond with the WWE Universe. Basically, when Kofi wins, they win.
And you can never, ever count Kofi Kingston out.
Kofi,
Kofi Kingston here, a superstar who will tell you himself why he loves to have fun and keep things light and positive. He still strives for greatness here in WWE, not just as a tag team competitor, but in a singles competition as well.
Absolutely. As soon as Kofi steps into the squared circle and that bell rings, he's out there to prove he's the very best.
Tonight, he has another chance to prove just that.
And Brock Lesnar opposite him. He may have thrown a cowboy hat on, but if anything, I think that's just made Lesnar more aggressive lately.
The only thing scarier than Brock when he's angry is Brock when he's happy.
He can do it here. Oh, he kicked out.
Not yet.
Kofi out of harm's way.
Textbook jumping clothesline.
Oof. And for Brock Lesnar, what should he do to earn the victory in this matchup?
Same thing he always does, whenever he wants. Part of the fun of being Brock Lesnar is that almost nobody can stop him once he gets going. Once he gets in control, he can relax and just do what feels natural.
Oh my, Seth Floyd was definitely not thinking about finesse with that one. Was only thinking about dominance.
Vicious right forearm.
Kofi Kingston looks stunned by that.
Delivering the suplex. Makes the cover. Oh my, how in the world did he kick out of that?
That's still a quick kick out at this point.
Oh my God, what an elbow. Effective arm drag. Getting in position. What's he planning to do here?
This is not a...
Oh, what a reversal and counter by him.
Sharp elbows to the body, looking to fight his way out. Hurricanrana, ideal meal.
And just like that, we kick the tempo up a notch.
Dodged right off cue.
It looks like Brock might be done playing with his food.
Man, just stay down. It can't be worth any more of this.
Looks like some words have been exchanged.
And body language is telling me they might not have been the time to
spoon. And this has got to be it. What does it take to keep this monster down?
All the punishment he's taken, and yet he's still in this match?
He eludes the contact.
Ooh!
Trouble for Lesnar.
There's two! I think Paul Heyman's heart just skipped a beat. Was that a wake-up call now for Brock Lesnar? Has it just angered the beast more?
And Kofi's starting to become disheartened. He's given everything tonight.
Oh my God!
You have to think these competitors expected this to be a difficult challenge.
Even so, at this stage, things just get more and more dangerous. Fatigue starts setting in, and you don't exactly have all your wits about you. It could quickly lead to error.
Corey, the superstars get right back in this match.
It's almost unbelievable what we're seeing with our own eyes.
Believe it, Corey, believe it.
Back body drop. Exclamation point.
Spinebuster.
Brought to the knee.
Kofi gets out of the way.
Oh, my goodness.
Out.
What a win. What a victory tonight.
Yeah, Brock had to. Kofi had to tap there, guys. He had no choice. What the hell now? Oh, here we go again.
Yeah, I was going to say celebrate, but maybe not.
Brock attacking Kofi after the match.
Somebody stop this idiot.
This isn't proving
anything. Not ideal. Deary me. Not the best of starts for Kofi, of course, in this rivalry, but Brock Lesnar, 0-3, picks up the win. We have another rivalry here. It's Eric and Ivar. Same scenario. Sorry, Ivar and Butch, begging my pardon. Sorry, Eric's actually in a match a little bit later. You'll see that, guys. So we have got our second match, and Butch is actually in a rivalry here. Jumping straight into the series. It is. Basically, as the lady said, formerly known as Pete Dunne. This one could be tricky for him, to be honest with you. Ivar's a monster. He was unbelievable in the last series of 2K22. Well, we get the same thing in 2K23, guys. Butch and Ivar, match two next.
The wild card of the Brawley Brutes.
Yeah, Cole, this dude's definitely not playing with a full deck.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring, representing the Brawling Brutes from Birmingham, England, weighing in at 205 pounds, Butch!
Whatever happened to the soft-spoken, calm competitor?
Oh, Cole, those days are done. D-U-N-N-E, done.
Yeah, now he's more like a rabid animal.
Butch ain't wrapped right, okay? He's not quite all there.
Yeah, but that's what makes him so dangerous. The raid has arrived. 6'2", over 300 pounds. Ivar moves like a man half his size.
And his opponent, representing the Viking Raiders from Valhalla, weighing in at 305 pounds, Ivar!
Is the larger and the more experienced member of the Raiders, trained by the great Killer Kowalski.
Deceptively agile and fast for a man of his size. Member of a tag team that has run roughshod all over NXT and beyond.
Butch in the ring and ready to get this fight started.
That's exactly what it's going to be, Cole. A fight. Butch doesn't concern himself with the destination. He's focused on the journey. And his idea of a journey is one that inflicts pain and suffering. I thought his brute brethren were unhinged and violent until they introduced us to Butch.
I would liken Butch to an animal, Corey, but I don't think animals fight with the hollow vitriol that Butch does.
And across the ring is Ivar, a one-of-a-kind party animal. Enjoys throwing himself headlong into combat and feasting with a large hunk of meat.
Ivar certainly does have a zest for life, and you're right about his love of combat. Few superstars look as at home in the ring as Ivar. You can tell this Viking was born for battle.
And they just busted out an impactful maneuver. Headbutt to the back of the neck. I can't imagine what is going through your head when you're facing off against an opponent as unhinged as Butch.
Well, if you're not careful, it'll be Butch's fist that goes through your head. You can't out-brawl him.
And he could pin his opponent right here. And he breaks the count quickly.
Kicking out there really has to make his opponent question his game plan.
continuously executing his game plan.
And I don't see Butch slowing down anytime soon.
Clubbing blow to the back. Oh, my! I don't think Ivar enjoyed taking that attack head-on.
Yeah, and Butch focused on taking his pound of flesh from his opponent there.
Now that's what you call impact.
What's this, Corey?
I think they're looking for the Romero special.
Oh, no.
Is it bananas?
It's cinched in. I think we're just moments away.
He needs to find an escape route.
Nice.
Suplex delivered.
And he's out of there in a nick of time.
And returning to the ring.
Kick to the gut.
Double underhook.
Target bomb.
Oh, this is just disrespectful.
And an elbow drop for added measure.
Boom, right across the small of the back.
He's feeling the effects of that last hit. And he goes into the ring. Ooh, headbutt. Oh,
nothing pretty about that.
Oh, no, this isn't going to end well. Double stomp to the legs. And he's able to counter. Springboard clothesline. Mistake made by Ivar. Oh my goodness, that might have snapped a finger. Great reaction from Ivar. Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Ooh, he's pulling the trachea.
And it's reverse pain for that mistake.
He takes control.
He must have had that scouted.
Guys, we could be looking at the start of one of the all-time great sports entertainment rivalries.
Way to put the cart before the horse, Cole. Sure, there's potential here. There always is. But they're not exactly having to be ripped apart from each other yet.
Oh, that'll keep Butch at bay.
Come up with a clothesline.
Stomping down!
This is just establishing dominance, followed by a stomp.
He is just reeling from that offense.
Shoulders down, this could be it.
And a kick out.
He really thought that was it.
He thinks he has it.
Getting the shoulder up before two.
This isn't even close to over.
Look at this.
Oh,
suicide dive. Absolutely throwing all caution to the wind.
Spitting in the face of danger.
Into a mat slam.
Well, this is a warning to grab our stuff and go.
Keep it in the ring, please. Saxton's a very fragile boy.
Suplex! And Ivar is taking control in this match.
Wow, Butch's short fuse leading to mistakes as his opponent takes advantage. Stiff elbow will break that up.
At last, Butch keeping that string of offense in check.
Brief sign of adrenaline from Butch.
Time to wallow in disbelief. Pressure must be kept on. What's it gonna take to keep this guy down?
Butch looking for it. There it is.
Butch has all but ended this.
For the win.
Two.
And Butch, a.k.a. Pete Dunne, grabs the victory against Ivar. I'd still be a shock, to be honest. And now it's Butch's turn to beat down. We've got Brock Lesnar. Now we've got Butch. Not the best match of the series, to be honest. I wasn't a big fan of that, but not much chemistry between the two guys. So we're just getting through the second match now, guys. Here we go. And now on to match three. Ah, okay. This one should be interesting. We've got a new... We've got two debuts in the series, guys. We've had one previously with Ivar and Butch. So two debuts so far. And now we've got some more people. We've got, of course, that in your head, Ed Alcantara. He's back, of course. But we've got Shanky and Eric from the Viking Raiders. We've already seen Ivar get beat already. Let's see how this one goes, ladies and gentlemen. Gunther, Intercontinental Champion, Shanky and Ivar. Match three, Triple Threat next.
Here comes the Austrian anomaly, Gunther.
A man with one purpose, to prove the mat sacred.
The following contest is a triple threat match. Making his way to the ring, representing Imperium from Vienna, Austria, weighing in at 297 pounds, the WWE Intercontinental Champion, Gunther.
Without question, Gunther has made an immediate impact since his arrival.
A truly dominant specimen.
And a specimen who is as ready as ever to chop clean through the competition.
Hey, he puts others to the test, and they often come up short. He moves with such a purpose, absolutely no wasted energy.
Well, that's because Gunther is saving himself completely for the battle ahead.
Yeah, but he does manage to make his entrance as intimidating as possible.
The skyscraping Shanky is here.
And his opponents, first from India, weighing in at 341 pounds, the skyscraping Shanky.
How great is it to finally see Shanky breaking free from Jinder Mahal?
Only a fool would reject the guidance of a former WWE champion. Saxton, sit down. Stop dancing. You look foolish.
I can't help it. My hips are on fire. Woo-hoo! The raid is here.
The battle-scarred Viking, Eric.
Representing the Viking Raiders from Valhalla, weighing in at 247 pounds, Eric!
It's time to raid and get paid. Eric was a top competitor in Japan before arriving in WWE, where he previously had battles against Ivar.
Now, Eric, also a true Rocky Miracle. This is a man who got into a motorcycle accident in 2014 and was told he shouldn't have ever survived, but he defied the odds and made his illustrious return inside the ring.
Eric, since that day, has lived by the motto that he is, in fact, hard to kill.
Three superstars in the ring, but only one victor in this triple threat matchup. Hashtag triple threat.
Simple rules. First competitor to earn a fall, whether by pinfall or submission, will be the winner.
The rules may be simple, but nothing is going to come easy in this fight. I assure you of that.
Oh, what a clothesline! And he sends him into the corner. Knife-edge chop, jumping neckbreaker. Ouch.
outside the ring now. He has no need to rush. Overhead chop. Caught with a big boot.
On the mark.
Oh, the sledgehammer connects.
That'll scramble your insides.
Being carried around with ease. Ooh, that's a shocking throat.
I've said it once, I've said it a thousand times. In a triple threat match, you absolutely have to keep your head on the swivel. You can't just focus on one opponent, because the second you do, the other can easily sneak in and change the complexion of this match.
Oh, swinging neck breaker. Able to reverse. To the outside.
This could get wild.
And there was some force on that move.
Continues the better part of valor.
Real European uppercut. And fires back. Well, he's got him here. He's got him up.
And oh! Well placed kick.
Couldn't quite slam the Not the position you want to be in right now.
Oh, man, right to the esophagus.
And that prevents Gunther's offense. Yes. Boom. Nice.
Sledgehammer right to the gut. Got it. I bet sledgehammer can cause some serious damage. Gunther, just a force of
this can do it. He stops the count.
Vicious right for him.
Uh-oh. It's the crossface.
And he got in there.
I thought that was it.
Good golly, Miss Molly.
He's getting a little battered now. Oh, man. Turns that into a devastating shot to the knee.
Uh-oh, smash.
Tossed into the corner. Shoulder tackle. The stirring impact. He can end it here.
At this point in the match, that could have gone either way.
Oh, knee smashing the face.
Roundhouse kick.
Great wherewithal on the counter.
Brilliant countering by both competitors.
Suplex. Here it comes.
Nicely done.
Perhaps looking for some kind of equalizer here.
The steel chair.
Looks like he's opted to go with the simple but effective statement here. Oh, God.
Oh, I hope they back up. They're getting too close for comfort.
Well, no one's paying attention to you, Saxon. They're too busy beating the tar out of each other. Heading back to the ring. No, 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 no. Power bomb out of the apron. And a well-executed move we just saw there.
Snapping the neck.
Cover, cover. Dying kick out there.
So resilient.
Stomping. Ouch.
Big boy.
Getting him in the corner. Headbutt to the back of the neck. What a chancery.
Just a perfect mix of pure power and bad intentions.
Oh my God, what impact. This one is headed outside, guys. He's outside the ring now.
Hope he's got a plan.
And that was an effective attack, guys. Saw that
one coming. And now gets tossed into the ring. Got to find a way to get out of this.
Uh-oh.
No! Lights out. Face first. We might be close to the end.
This is a very dangerous situation now.
Gunther wants to finish this.
Gunther, Eric.
Death by Eric.
That's it. Gunther is out.
Oh, he was almost finished.
What an amazing level of fight still left in Gunther.
It must be demoralizing knowing you've unleashed your best shot on your opponent to no avail. Looking worse for wear in the corner now.
He may get the break out.
Here is your winner.
It's the way I suggested this match should be won. Eric and Shanky maybe beat up Gunther. They didn't in the end. But incapacitate Gunther. And then one of the other two beat each other, and it was Eric who defeated Shanky. That was a really, really fun, hard-hitting match, actually. I didn't think it'd be that good, to be honest, but it was really fun. Eric wins. First victory of the series. Now we've got a new rivalry. Batista versus Sheamus. Is it going to be that match? It is. So we've got Batista the Animal, former multiple-time WWE champion and World Heavyweight Champion, of course. Sure, first ballot Hall of Famer. Pretty much should be a Hall of Famer already. I guess a future Hall of Famer himself in the Celtic Warrior. Sheamus. Two hard-hitting behemoths. Match four, rivalry begins next.
The following is scheduled for 1-4, making his way to the ring from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 290 pounds, the Animal Batista!
A multiple-time World Heavyweight Champion, a Royal Rumble winner, Batista has earned his spot atop WWE.
A founding member of Evolution, but the Animal himself has evolved to the top of the food chain in this industry.
Oh, man, he is going to be in for the battle of his life against Sheamus.
No way he leaves this one without a few scars.
It's fight night!
And his opponent, representing the Brawling Brutes, from Dublin, Ireland, weighing in at 267 pounds, the Celtic Warrior, Sheamus!
Nearly 15 years into his WWE career, Sheamus still manages to deliver banger after banger.
Okay.
After banger.
We got it.
After banger.
Would you stop?
After banger.
Oh, my gosh.
After banger.
Quiet.
After banger.
Shut up.
After banger.
I love it.
After banger. After banger.
Heading into this one, Sheamus said the disregard for his accomplishments is a disgrace, and it's time he's recognized for his greatness.
That doesn't sound like a difficult thing to ask, Cole. Sheamus just wants his due respect. Appreciate this man's dominance and accomplishments.
No one's dismissing Sheamus. He has a Hall of Fame career, and he's fully capable of allowing his actions to speak for him tonight.
And we know Batista is powerful, but can that power last for the duration of the match?
Batista's an insane specimen, Saxton. An altered beast who is as ferocious as ever. I would never bet against the animal's capabilities.
Down he goes.
Elbow drop. And he goes for the pin. Only a one count before the kick out.
Fighting hard to stay in this match.
That could be it.
Gets the shoulder. Wow. What's it going to take?
Just using the adrenaline to stay in the match. We're no closer to a winner just yet.
Corey, we know Batista's powerful, but has been a Hollywood star for a number of years. How will his time spent away from WWE affect him?
Well, it's difficult to measure the extent of a long layoff. However, with Batista, his training during time away includes Gracie Jiu-Jitsu, so his mat game stayed sharp. So, the better strategy might be to keep distance so the animal doesn't utilize his MMA skill set.
Oh, look at the start of this. Could be going into the playbook for submission.
Wow, the power that takes is insane.
Look at this. That's a great escape. Getting set up for something in the corner. And that was an efficient display of offense with that maneuver. Getting carried. Unsure what they're thinking. And with his shoulders are down.
He's still in the fight, but for how much longer?
Batista able to ward that.
What a slam. Big time.
Jarring spine buster by Batista.
The animal just lived up to his moniker. His sustained power is off the charts.
Power like this is why he's destroyed the careers of so many superstars.
You know, I've noticed some friction lately between these superstars.
Well, you can't be friends with everybody.
I've noticed the same. There's definitely something of a rivalry here.
Oh, my goodness.
And that was an efficient form of offense with that move.
That was a showing of control and aggression, something they'll want to keep up.
Neckbreaker.
Batista is just playing with his food right now.
Counter from the Celtic Warrior. Oh, the Celtic Warrior. One of the most physical men in WWE history.
Ooh. We're seeing why.
Cover. Shoulders are down. It easily stops the ref's count.
Frankly, he should have known that wasn't enough.
Put in a position now.
Batista just unleashed on him. Could be a sign of things to come.
Can he do it here? No, shoulders up at two.
Very close. The T clearly setting in.
How's that for a counter?
Ah, Sheamus.
That'll do it with the Irish curse.
Batista looks knocked out.
What a kick out at two.
That was an unbelievable kick out from Batista.
The unmitigated power of Sheamus was not enough to put this away. The Celtic Warrior is going to have to hit even harder to end this. You have to imagine we're hitting the late stages of this matchup. Who's going to dig deeper at this point?
We might just take that extra push, that extra inch further to create the difference. He refuses to stay down.
Pure in Batista. Batista by submission. Look at all that.
One blow, all it took.
What energy in the arena tonight. Just carrying the opposition anywhere they want.
Straight up down the throat.
And Sheamus is countered.
Clearly waiting for that.
Sheamus inciting the fans in attendance. Oh, red in there. Locks in the gut wrench. And that was a precisely measured attack.
And an elbow drop, too.
He's heading up top.
Thinking big.
From the top.
Elbow drop. Good Lord.
And a cover for the win. What a win for this.
The pole may have been tied, but Batista grabs the win. What now?
And this superstar Batista earned the right to be the victor.
Batista. Oh, Batista. With a chair. Uh-oh. Oh, God.
A statement made tonight.
Oh, Batista. Unnecessary violence. Absolute statement made by Batista there. Grueling match once again. Three views, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Did go to six a minute ago, but bloody hell. But I'll say he doesn't know when to make his mind up. Thank you very much for watching. Hope you're having a lovely afternoon, of course, as we are fast approaching the weekend. Jimmy Uso and Giovanni Vinci coming up now. So this is match five already. In fact, this show's been pretty quick, to be fair. Average match time of about 10 minutes is what you're looking for, especially with a triple threat in it. Jimmy Uso, the man who's been on incredible form. The former Fabian Aichner. Now known as Giovanni Vinci, representing Imperium. Jimmy, I can't wait till Volta goes up against Roman Reigns. That'll be fucking amazing. But Jimmy Uso, Giovanni Vinci for the moment. Match five next.
Welcome to the Uso Penitentiary.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Making his way to the ring, representing the Usos from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 251 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, Jimmy Uso.
Jimmy and Jey Uso have single-handedly transformed the tag team division. You know, and if you ask them what made the difference, what made you guys step up your game, Jimmy and Jey will tell you it was the moment we decided to stop being what other people expected us to be and to start being who we are.
And I've been down a lot longer than you have.
match.
And his opponent, representing Imperium from South Tyrol, Italy, weighing in at 220 pounds, Giovanni Vinci!
A man who believes the mat is sacred, but why not look good doing it?
His resume looks good too. Multiple NXT tag title reigns and complete dominance alongside Imperium.
We are about to see a picture-perfect performance, courtesy of Giovanni Vinci.
And he's certain to make Imperium proud. When it comes to in-ring competitors, Giovanni Vinci is just about as polished and intimidating as they come.
Chucked around like that.
Uh-oh. Jawbreaker!
Call the dentist.
He saw it coming. Jimmy timed that one. Brain Buster!
Watch out! They're coming towards the announce desk!
What the hell are you doing, Byron?
Dropkick finds the spot.
Oh, strong impact. How do you deal with a superstar like Giovanni Vinci, who has so many offensive and defensive tools inside the ring?
You have to match the versatility of Vinci. Mix up your attacks, be dynamic. Try moves he can't easily counter. The more variety you bring, the harder it'll be for him to get one step ahead.
Great power.
Crashing down.
Samoan drop. And Jimmy realizing he's not the only one in this match willing to do anything it takes.
What an attack there by Vinci. Expertly controlling his power.
Oh my goodness. And that definitely made solid impact. Jimmy gets intercepted.
Saxton.
One, two, three.
We could be here
four.
All day.
Power.
Three. I think you're right.
That was a hell of a maneuver there, guys.
Four.
He's turning the tables.
Five.
And gets tossed back into the mat.
Six.
Into the corner he goes. A perfectly placed target. And Jimmy able to reverse that. Ducked underneath.
German suplex turns the tides.
Oh, man. Right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow. This could be it. Cover. Powering out at one.
Not time to expect victory yet.
Submission.
submission.
How in the world do you get out of this?
I guess just like that.
Beautiful athleticism.
Hurricane Rana.
Will somebody call that showing off? What a display. What a way to flaunt your abilities. Jimmy Uso is feeling it. He is getting that energy level back up.
Ooh. Taking a trip outside, but he's got to be mindful of the count.
And he tosses him back in now.
All right.
Jimmy on his way to the top rope. What grace. Float over.
Float over. Nice. DDT.
He catches Jimmy with a counter.
A counter answered by another counter. Reciprocating the initial reverse.
A bear hug. Squeezing the breath out of them. What a unique submission maneuver here. And look at the pain his opponent's in. Bear hug. Well placed elbow. We'll get you out of it.
That might be enough. Yes, it is.
Oh, the close of this match is just ahead.
Maybe just stay down, man. You've done enough.
Here he goes for the win. Shoulder up.
I thought for sure he was done.
The competitive spirit is alive and well in this one.
Yeah, I think these superstars are actually
top rope.
Uso splash. And she's down. And he might be out.
So look out. Three. No. Two count.
I can't believe that this whole arena's in shock.
Yeah, but no one's more shocked than the man who thought he had a pinfall.
What's the tally? How many times we thought this match was coming to an end?
If this lands, it might be home.
Uh-oh.
Moved at the right time.
Uh-oh.
Close on the back of the neck.
A bear hug. And he's just in reach of the ropes and gets it to force the break.
The ropes become a competitor's best friend in desperate moments like that one.
Ooh, avoided the attack with a nasty chop lock.
Stops the attack with a hit to the gut.
Superstars must be hurt, must be vulnerable.
And who's going to find a way to capitalize on that vulnerability?
He's got him scouted.
Right to the kidneys from behind.
German suplex.
The colossal clutch.
Now look at this, locked in. Submission move here.
This won't win the match, but it's doing a lot of damage in the process.
Right underneath, and just like that, he's out of the hole. They need to be aware of a count out right now. Brought back into the ring from the floor now.
Giovanni looking like he means business right now. I wouldn't want to mess with him.
Lighten up the chest.
And Vinci is keeping the match at his pace.
Yeah, Jimmy keeps getting cut down at every move.
Wiped out with the crossbody. Two. Oh, somehow managed to keep this match going. Jimmy saw it coming. Ooh, what a slap.
Here we go.
No surprise that what we're witnessing is trending. Forget trending on social media. The motion in the arena is charting on the Richter scale. Oh, impressive counter. Vinci. Spinning sit-out powerbomb.
Vinci stamping an end to this.
And they earned that victory. What a win.
I agree. The WWE Universe hallway to...
Wait a minute. Here we go. Jey Uso's going to attack Giovanni Vinci. He's not Vinci. 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 Get him over the ropes. I like how Jimmy Uso's hair has changed because he's gotten a little bit more tired. That's a pretty cool feature. Back in the olden days, the hair never used to change when they were in wrestling. That's a really good feature. I'm very impressed with that. I'll explain that to you, Mrs. when we're between the next match. Giovanni Vinci picks up a very, very impressive victory over Jimmy Uso. I'd probably say that's up there with match of the night so far. Obviously, the guys in the comments, you guys can choose which one you want to do. Jimmy Uso loses. Awesome stuff. Now then, my views went from 4 to 2, maybe at the wrong time. Because now we've got the two friends squaring off. It is Shayna Baszler, the former NXT Women's Champion. The lady who kind of came up through WWE whilst being a mixed martial artist, but she's taken on arguably the greatest martial art mixed MMA lady of all time, most famous anyway, probably not the best. The pioneer. I've spelled fucking Rousey wrong as well, but Rousey. Here we go, guys. We've got Ronda Rousey, Shayna Baszler, match 6, gonna be a belter. Next.
The Queen of Spades about to grace the WWE Universe with true submission expertise.
The following is scheduled for 1 fall, making her way to the ring from Sioux Falls, South Dakota. The Queen of Spades, Shayna Baszler.
A women's MMA pioneer. In fact, Shayna Baszler finished most of her matches by submission.
And those skills have translated to WWE Women's Division dominance.
She holds the record for most women's Royal Rumble eliminations and women's Elimination Chamber eliminations. It doesn't matter if she has one opponent or 29, in the ring or in a chamber, Shayna Baszler is always ready to fight. When the mouth guard goes in, the lights go out for her opponent. Ronda Rousey's back.
And from Venice Beach, California, the SmackDown Women's Champion, the baddest woman on the planet, Ronda Rousey.
Rousey doesn't get paid by the hour. We're going to end this quick.
I'm not sure anyone can stop Ronda Rousey.
I've never agreed with you more, Saxton.
She's competed all over the world in a number of combat disciplines. She's trained extensively in MMA, judo, and wrestling.
Yeah, few people know the art of combat inside and out the way Ronda does. And more impressively, she's found no shortage of success in every one of those different arenas she's competed in.
That's right, winning fights is just what Ronda Rousey does.
And then you have Shayna Baszler, who just loves to remind everyone that she's an actual fighter, who really doesn't care about being a sports entertainer or a superstar.
Saxton, show even an ounce of respect, okay? Shayna Baszler is a pioneer in women's MMA, and because of that, she brings a fighter's mentality to the squared circle that pretty much all of her peers lack. Loss. Her shoulders are down. She was close to the end there.
The end was in sight.
She did her homework there. Shayna's told the story of how she once teased her buddy Ronda in the middle of a grappling session about how she's never been caught in Rousey's armbar. Ronda's response was to immediately trap Baszler in her armbar and keep it applied for 2 agonizing minutes.
Well, I'd imagine Shayna learned 2 valuable lessons from that. 1, how to anticipate Ronda's signature submission. 2, never taunt the baddest woman on the planet.
A second gut-wrench suplex.
Being able to pull that off, no one is going to question if you skip going to the gym today.
Backdrop. Will this be enough?
Great officiating as the ref noticed she was on the ropes.
Oh, this is where Baszler's at her nastiest. God. Oh, look at this. Can't even watch.
No respect being shown whatsoever with those stomps.
And that was taking the attack to the competition with that one.
Got the leg.
Well placed elbow to the leg. And right there, Shayna being shown that her competition isn't lacking a fighter's mentality themselves.
Ronda just so well versed in the art of combat. It allows her to get the best of her opponent.
She goes for the pin. Manages to escape before the 3 count.
No celebrations yet.
Heads out of the ring, but needs to be mindful of the referee's count here. Bad predicament right here.
Oh, man.
And Ronda's maintaining the advantage now.
Rousey keeping Baszler from making any comeback.
You have to imagine the disdain it takes to repeatedly stop someone like that.
3! Boom! Powerbomb!
That powerbomb was absolutely worthy of both halves of its name.
Plenty of hits coming her way now. Oh no! Stop to the arm!
Getting the upper hand by taking away your opponents.
Goes under the ropes to get back inside.
Plenty left to go in this one.
Oh, toss across. Right into a drop. The elbow to the arm. Scratching and clawing. This could be it. Oh, no.
That is just pure instinct at this point.
Off the ropes.
Brutal knee to the side of the face. Ronda Rousey with a takedown. Look at the cinch in the armbar. There it is. Ronda Rousey, submission specialist, looking for her bread and butter. There it is. Armbar applied.
Man, she's
trying to somehow maneuver their body out of this submission. Dropping bombs, and they're free.
One response after another, back and forth we go.
Rousey heads up high. just spilled out to the ringside area. And as we can see, tension's really running high now.
Yeah, we should probably clear the way, guys.
Sky high. What a forearm smash. This could do it. Almost had her.
This started as a match. Now it's a test of will.
Shayna Baszler's got her partway where she wants it. Back down.
Sixth in. This one's over. This one's over. Baszler, moments away, closing in on a submit.
Look at this, Corey. Look at this.
Fighting her way out.
How did she break that hole?
Spectacular. Kicked out.
Rousey has her up. A Rowdy Buster. Is it enough? The cover. Oh, a kick out. How did she do that?
That sucked all the air out of this place. It looked like a done deal.
All right, after the aggressor. Nice takedown. Nice job getting to the ropes.
And when you're in that position, you have no other choice.
And Baszler had it scouted right across the face.
What must be going through Shayna Baszler's mind? How did Rousey even stay?
What an amazing performance by both superstars. This is a primal fight for survival.
I was sure this one was over.
Scratching, doing whatever it takes. She will not let this match end.
She returns the favor. That
was able to grab her opponent.
Incredibly important moment right there, being able to get to the ropes.
It can't be understated how much that could have just saved this match. Rolling into a monkey flip.
Very, very slow match to start with that. But Ronda Rousey coming through. Great end sequence. Just positional awareness in the ring. And Shayna loses her momentum.
Former friend Shayna Baszler.
What a match. What a fight.
They're friends. I don't think it really matters, really, to be honest. Four-star match up there again. The matches are getting better as we move through the card. Speaking of hard-hitting, ladies and gentlemen, this one is going to be brutal. Brock Lesnar, the Beast, versus Big E. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Match seven. These two, it's not going to be for the faint of heart this one, guys. These guys are going to just run into each other like bulldozers. Lesnar and Big E, match seven, let's go.
Here comes the Beast.
The most dominant competitor in WWE history. Thank you.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing in at 295 pounds, Brock Lesnar!
The Beast Incarnate has been involved in some of WWE's biggest matches.
He's always a spectacle to see in action.
And there are undoubtedly more unforgettable moments on their way. It's time to do it the Cowboy way.
You think there's any limit at all to the carnage that's to come here tonight?
Oh, Saxton, you know better. We should expect nothing short of total decimation.
Of course, Lesnar's never one for holding back.
The Beast wins decisively.
The Beast wins by ripping guys apart.
Time to think big.
And his opponent, representing the New Day, from Tampa, Florida, weighing in at 285 pounds, Big E!
It's all about the movement of smiles and positivity.
One of the most powerful men on the WWE roster.
Got a little extra pep in his step here tonight.
Big E's ready for battle. Competition here tonight looks as focused as he ever has, maybe even more so.
We know Big E knows how to turn it on when the lights shine bright, and tonight is no different. This is a Big E to be feared.
Certainly a Big E to be watched closely.
And then there is the Brock Lesnar, a superstar seemingly built to destroy and conquer anyone who steps foot in his path.
Now, I honestly can't imagine standing across the road from Lesnar and not playing the greatest hits of all the battles he's won, all the superstars he's so emphatically dominated. On a loop in your brain, the man definitely has a well-deserved reputation.
I honestly can't believe we just saw a human being tossed like that.
Wow, touch to the gut.
I'll pick the wind right out of you.
Straight to the knee.
An effective attack to the leg can hurt everything from balance to mobility. It can drastically limit you inside the ring.
Oh, right to the spine with the knee.
That was vicious.
Unloading with an uppercut.
Big E starting to slow down a bit here.
Is it enough here? Just kicks out.
You have to think this battle is starting to weigh down on him.
Brock Lesnar, the Beast, unleashed. F5.
Is that all she wrote for Big E?
He, no way, no way.
What a kick out. The power of positivity lives on.
Big E used to say 3 ain't enough, and clearly that goes both ways.
Lesnar is pissed off now. Lesnar doesn't get paid by the hour. He wanted this to be over seconds ago.
Sent into the corner.
Ooh, here he goes for the win.
to the gut, too.
Get slammed down.
Taking flight. Diving body splash.
Two. No, stops the count at two.
This is no time to hesitate. You can feel the end coming.
Just one final blow away from not kicking out next time.
Good golly, what a knee.
That move looks to have stymied Big E.
Such forceful velocity behind every one of Lesnar's attacks.
Ah, blow to the breadbasket.
Drop suplex.
Front face lock applied. It's about to get more painful.
Top. Oh, here he goes for the win.
Then he closes it out. Kicks out. He still has life.
Getting dangerously close to ending it all there.
Just like that, Big E finds a counter.
Big E with the big ending. Will that clinch things for Big E?
Two.
Lesnar is so feared. That there was Exhibit A. The beast does not die.
There's no smile on Big E's face right now after that kick out. He knows he has to be all business.
What a battle we are witnessing.
We're at a stage where someone's going to have to shift it into another gear.
Was ready for that.
Tagged with a punch.
Yeah, this is a dire situation right now.
This is when Big E really needs to hear that New Day Rock chant and get those massive hip flexors moving.
Okay, but leave the table. Go start your chant.
I will.
The referee counting, urging them to get in the ring. Taking it outside the ring now. Held in a perilous position. Back inside. Big E letting his opponent know that he is all business now.
Six.
Clothesline knockdown. Here we go. Comeback time.
This superstar's on fire.
Pace begins to quicken.
A major victory there. Lesnar battered and bruised before the match even started. Thanks to his war with Santos Escobar, Hell in the Cell.
Took everything they had.
Big E.
And then some. I am awestruck, gentlemen. We just witnessed
awesome by Big E.
Overcome the beast incarnate.
Big E looks like he's going to be going after Roman Reigns. Looking awesome, Big E, in that match. Is that the stepping stone that he needed to go after Roman Reigns? Speak of the devil, co-main event time, ladies and gentlemen. The tribal chief, the head of the table, Roman Reigns. The man who stopped Matt Riddle at Hell in a Cell. Now gets to take on his cousin once again to avenge the earlier series loss. It is Roman Reigns, main event Jey Uso, co-main event next.
Guess what, folks? It's time to acknowledge the Tribal Chief.
The following champion versus champion contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Pensacola, Florida, weighing in at 265 pounds, the undisputed WWE Universal Champion, Roman Reigns!
Well, here's a man who's held the Universal Championship for over 2 years.
Greatness redefined. That's God mode.
Part of the pantheon of all-time greats in the WWE. You can count on one hand the amount of people who've held the championship as long as Roman Reigns.
By the looks of things, Roman Reigns is ready to continue his unparalleled domination.
Welcome to the USO Penitentiary!
And his opponent, representing the USOs from San Francisco, California, weighing in at 242 pounds, one half of the Raw Tag Team Champions, main event, Jey Uso!
Jey Uso has grown accustomed to owning a mountain of tag team gold.
No, get up!
But he's proven he can fly solo as well, Byron.
You can say that again, Cole. We are looking at main event Jey Uso, as ruthless as they come. The right-hand man.
That's it.
You cannot allow Reigns to intimidate you.
Yeah, well, that's probably easier said than done. He is in for the fight of his life.
Jey Uso is about as tough and proud as they come, but for the life of me, I don't get this match. If you're Jey, why would you jeopardize your standing with the Tribal Chief?
You have to understand, Corey, Jey Uso has lived his whole life by his association to others. He wants to be known as his own man, not Jimmy's brother, not Roman's cousin, not Rikishi's son. Just main event, Jey Uso.
Jey puts a stop to that.
Oh, he's looking to completely render this leg useless.
Stump puller, leg snap.
That's going to hurt.
Tear your hamstring.
Oh, he fights Jey back. Strong suplex. Nope.
Oh, my goodness. Ah, what a smash.
That is just insulting.
He thinks he has it.
Kicks out at just one.
Starting to see the tolls of this match add up.
Repositioning their opponent. Looks like a neck breaker.
Ooh, bang!
Looking for the submission move. Set of the ball. The Boston Crab.
Look at the back position.
Nicely done.
Oh, my goodness. Kick to the spine.
And Roman Reigns not just trying to win a match tonight, but make a statement to his cousin. How does he do that?
Showcase his power in every sense of the word. Don't be shy with those big strikes, and trust you'll be able to settle family differences later.
Set up in the corner of the ring.
Ooh!
Oh, he retaliates.
Jey out of there in a hurry.
And we just saw some serious offense. Headbutt!
Look at this, just unloading. And a stomp to the gut, too.
Just punched him right in the mouth.
could do it. He forces a break before the count of two.
Not yet.
Jumping clothesline. What agility. With the counter.
Setting up for something here.
Tossed aside. No other way to say it, guys. That looked like it hurt a lot.
They slipped. That should do it right there.
A kick at it, too.
Really had less than a second to stay alive there.
And Jay reverses. Boom! What a slap.
There he goes, right into the corner.
Boom! Boom! Kick to the face for your troubles.
Getting carried around. Bad spot to be in. Down the window.
Talk about dismantling your opponent.
Ah, right to the back.
Basement drop kick.
He finds a counter for Jay.
Kick.
Insulting.
What a suplex.
Oh, Roman Reigns locked and loaded, measuring his opponent. Here we go.
Reigns got all of it.
That's gotta be it.
Two count.
Dominant performance. Absolutely dominant. Roman Reigns, didn't he? Look, he's not even broke a sweat hardly.
Jey Uso showed the heart of a lion tonight, but in the end, he was forced to acknowledge.
Jey did all right, but nowhere near Roman's level. We were just talking a minute ago, who is going to be the one to stop Roman Reigns? I really don't know. Seth, I would love to see Gunther in this one. Guys, we're going to get up our rating poll now, of course. So we're going to do that actually now. Stay tuned, guys. I'll be back in 1 minute. Sorry about the delay there, guys. We are back. Was just sorting out the raid poll. We're going to be going up with that in literally 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Ladies and gentlemen, get the game that you want to be voted in for the raid. It is live. We got Undertaker 03 in the main event of SmackDown, taking on Santos Escobar, who recently just beat Brock Lesnar. This one's going to be huge, ladies and gentlemen. Undertaker versus Santos, main event next.
Here comes Hell on Wheels.
No introduction needed.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Death Valley, weighing in at 305 pounds, the Undertaker.
A metamorphosis of destruction is on display. He may not dress like Satan himself anymore, but he's still down with the devil and ready to get medieval tonight.
The dead man's opponent is about to fight for his life.
Yeah, the dead man loves to dish out punishment.
And I'm sure tonight will be no different.
And his opponent, accompanied by Cruz del Toro, representing Legado del Fantasma from Mexico City, Mexico, weighing in at 200 pounds, Santos Escobar.
Gentlemen, I think this one's going to turn into a fight in a hurry, and I cannot wait.
I know this is almost impossible to do, but somehow this superstar has got to put the mind games aside. It cannot show fear against The Undertaker, or else this superstar will rest in peace.
We'll start with Santos Escobar, the self-styled Emperor of Lucha Libre. What does that even mean, Corey?
No!
Slingshot cross body! Cover! Gets his shoulder up before the two count.
He's still in this.
Reversal catches Santos. Great strength being shown here.
Just one step ahead.
A stalemate of counters.
Big hook. Able to interrupt the attack.
Wrist lock applied.
Oh, man, look at this power.
Corey, how do you plan for a superstar like Santos Escobar?
Escobar has a hybrid offense, mixing lucha tradition with modern aggression. If you want to defeat him, you need to be able to weather the early storm and not let your guard down.
Hammer it away! Axe handle from the middle rope. Hits him with the counter. Tossed with ease.
Just got thrown around like a sack of you know what.
Undertaker.
It's going for the
ref forces the
great effort though.
this match than we previously thought.
Ooh! Whoa!
Ooh, that hurt right to the kidney.
Golly.
Oh, what a shot. Can Undertaker withstand this onslaught?
Blend of that Lucha Libre style and power, keeping Escobar on top.
Oh, perfect kick. Oh, that was just malicious.
Insulting.
Toss back into the ring.
Check this out, guys. Double underhook coming.
Byron's gonna love this. The Dude Buster. There's a certain amount of anger you have to have towards your opponent to pile drive them like that.
Close call. That was almost lights out.
Uh-oh. Jawbreaker.
Call the dentist.
And the pressure being put on the Phenom there.
At this stage of the match, they are clearly starting to feel the effects of this back and forth.
Takes their breath out. Effective counter. A nice shot by the Undertaker.
Now one of the best strikers in the business.
Escobar able to dodge that.
Oh, chin-breaking uppercut. Reversal by the Undertaker. Planning on what to do next.
Things are getting risky. This will not end well.
Nasty. The hardest part of the ring. And he slides him back to the mat.
Escobar connecting with the Phantom Driver.
That's it. Santos just ended things.
Two.
Oh, kick out. Kick out at two.
We've seen this time after time. You cannot keep the Undertaker down.
When your opponent can hang after all that, you're wondering if running a win might just be impossible.
So much torque on the knee and ankle.
Escobar showing no fear up there.
Lift off.
This is back.
Close to three.
With the damage sustained by Undertaker, he could be on his way out.
Yeah, not looking good at all.
Go, go, go. And Escobar didn't see that coming. Boom! And a big boot. Boom to the elbow, finds the mark. For the victory here. A defiant kick out.
We are this far into the match. Where is this energy coming from?
Placed in the corner.
Lands the knee.
And this is just a vulgar display of ruthlessness.
Now, look at this ruthlessness in the bottom turnbuckle. Using the knee.
Now a series of vicious sounds in the turnbuckle.
Stunts.
A warning and a challenge from the Reaper to his opponent. And he'll leave the ring for this next stretch. Thrown back in under the ropes.
This is the beginning of the end. Here we go. Last ride. Feeling like it's over for Santos.
Two. Nine kicked out.
How close was that?
That was about as close as it could get without it all being over for him.
Seeing a little bit of shock on the Undertaker's face. He's ended so many matches this way, but not this one. Boom, just turn that around.
This is it.
Quick call. It's a new yoga technique. Relax.
The suspense this crowd is feeling is palpable.
They are waiting with bated breath for what's to come next.
He got whipped into that corner.
Big time move coming up. Big right hand to a dazed opponent. What are they thinking here? No way.
Gut bust into the cover. No, it's not over.
The fact that these superstars can still be moving at this point is beyond the realm of reality. Escobar has set his target.
Escobar connecting with the Phantom Driver.
Exclamation delivered by Escobar.
Amazing!
Oh my gosh! The Undertaker resists his demise.
Amazing resilience from the dead man.
This was the moment to capitalize on. That should have been the end.
Boom!
Nasty right hand. Hits a go.
A little style from the Emperor of Lucha Libre.
Take a steer clear.
Oh,
guys, they're getting way too close for comfort here.
Yeah, I've seen this before, and it doesn't end well. Okay, he's re-entering the ring.
This is the beginning of the end. Here we go! What devastation from the Undertaker.
Took some serious endurance, I'll give you that.
An unfamiliar look of shock from The Undertaker. He thought that was it.
Trying to find his bearings, but it looks like his end is near.
Look out.
Diving clothesline.
Does he get him here?
Oh, how?
I am shaking my head in disbelief over how he managed to get the shoulder up. Out of the way.
Into the corner now. He's positioned up on that turnbuckle.
Bad situation here. And it's about to get worse from the middle row.
Avalanche gut buster. Shifts it.
Top rope, putting it all on the line.
And his eyes are piercing through the opposition now.
Flying.
What? Just crashing down with high impact. Treading all over their opponent.
One over the 10th Street Slam.
Momentum on the side of the dead man.
He's weathered Escobar's hybrid offense and has not let his guard down whatsoever.
Powerless position to be in right now. And that was a successful bit of offense with that maneuver.
Heading back to the ring.
The Undertaker puts it away. The Undertaker with a tremendous win.
Here is your winner, The Undertaker.
That much of a hard-hitting match, ladies and gentlemen. That much of a hard-hitting match. They had to count him out. Santos couldn't get back up, but it was an unbelievable performance, and Undertaker rides off on the old motorbike. The good old Harley Davidson bike. And we, ladies and gentlemen, are going to race some equal quickles. We're going to start that raid now. Thank you very much for watching, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a pleasure once again. This is the only streamer today. We have got ourselves the pay-per-view tomorrow. It's going to be hell. No, it's not. Well, it's going to be hell. It's going to be in your house hell. Guys, thank you for watching. 5-star matchup. Well done there for Undertaker. Incapacitating. We've got him with the hashtag Gladray. That's hashtag Gladray. Guys, feel jumping. Got about another 5 seconds to get yourselves in. We are going to be back tomorrow with In Your House of Pay-Per-View. 14 matches, 8 rivalries settled, and some hella good show as per usual. Thank you for watching. All the best. And bye for now.